Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. Today we are making video on text. Okay, so initially we need to deal with text alignment, okay, text color, next text shadow, and like this we are making it in this video. Okay, so we are dealing with CSS text. So the first one is text color. The color property is used to set the color of the text. It gives the color of the text. So body, I am giving color is blue. So H1, the color is green, I mentioned. If you know the name, only we need to write names. Otherwise, we have two alternatives, that is hexa value and RGB values. Okay. So directly we need to give automatically what is the text we are typing in the content, the color will be reflected automatically. So the next one is text alignment. The text align property is used to set the horizontal alignment of a text. It may be a left or right aligned or centered or justified. Left means the text is aligned to left. Right means the text is aligned to right. Centered means within this order it gives like this. Justified means it takes to entire page, left and right will be adjusted. Okay, here I am using text align justify. Okay, so here we are using divs. I will explain you practically how we are doing it. Okay, so here H1 text is center, H2 text is left, H3 is right. We are giving three different text. Automatically the text will be aligned left, right, and center, left and right accordingly. Okay, so now text decoration. The text decoration property is used to set or remove decorations from text. The value text decoration none is often used to remove underlines from link. Okay, so the text decoration is none means nothing can be reflected. So when the text decoration is overline, okay, the next text decoration is line through, the text decoration is underline. I will tell you the example. Let us example, this is the text. Overline means above the text the line will be coming. Line through means in center the text will be line will be coming. Underline means the text under it comes. It is like U tag in text. Okay, so the next one is text transformation. The text transformation property is used to specify uppercase and lowercase letters in a text. It can be used to turn everything into uppercase or lowercase letters or capitalize the first letter of each word. So we need to convert entire text into uppercase. The text transformation is uppercase. The text transformation is lowercase. The text transformation is capitalized. Okay, automatically uppercase means everything should be capital. Lowercase means everything should be small. Capitalized means the first letter is capital. Okay, like this it will be working. Right, so next text indent. Actually indent means, let us take this is the page. What is the space we are giving? This space is called indent. The text indent property is used to specify the indentation of the first line of the text. So here it gives only, if it is a paragraph, only this part will be monetized. So the text indent is 50px, means 50 pixels per size will be ignored for this. So this is the indent space. Okay, so the next one is letter spacing. The letter spacing property is used to specify the space between the characters in a text. So H1 letter spacing 3px means letter to letter. So the letter, this space is 3px. Okay, so the letter spacing is minus 3px. Excuse me. The letter, it mixed the text. Okay, that is what exactly. So next is line height. The line height property is used to specify the space between lines. So This is the first line. The second line, the gap is specified as line height. So 0.7, 1.8 is given. So the next one is a text direction. The direction property is used to change the text direction of an element. Okay. So example, direction is RTL. So this is that. Okay. So how we are giving is 10px or minus px. The word spacing is the next one is word spacing. The word spacing property is used to specify the space between the words in a text. Okay. Here 10px and 5px. So if 10px, the will be printed like this. If it is minus 5px, the will be printed like this. This is the changes happened in here. So the next one is a text shadow. The text shadow property adds shadow to text. The text the syntax is text shadow, H space, horizontal shadow, vertical shadow, blur radius, and color none, initial or innate. We need to use any one of the property. So the property value H shadow is required. The position of the horizontal shadow, negative values are allowed. V shadow required. The position of the vertical shadow, negative values are allowed. Blur radius optional. The blur radius default value is 0. Color optional. The color of the shadow none, default value no shadow. Initial sets this property to its default value. Inherits this property from its parent element. Okay, so we need to change these properties, then the shadow will come in a better way. So the examples are the text shadow 2px means the horizontal shadow, vertical shadow, and we also mentioned the color. Okay, so the second example, this here it also mentioned blur radius. Okay, this is what exactly the concept of text changing effects. Okay, so in this video what we learned is the first one is text alignment, text color, text alignment, text decoration, text transformation, text indentation, letter spacing, line height, text direction, word spacing, text shadow, text shadow in this video. In the next session, we learn these things in a practical manner. Okay, so we will take different examples, and in this session also we introduced div sections, divisions in this way. Okay, thank you.